Real-time ray tracing visual effects for Minecraft are finally here, in a beta format, at least. If you have a compatible NVIDIA RTX graphics card and you're running the Windows 10 version of Minecraft, you can sign up for the beta right now to access a collection of worlds designed with real-time lighting and shadows, full-color global illumination, enhanced transparency and distortion effects for glass and water, and more graphical flair that makes everyone's favorite block-based tree-punching simulator look better than anyone ever imagined when the game first released back in 2009. Right now, in the beta, RTX Minecraft is playable via 6 worlds designed by Minecraft creators working closely with NVIDIA. By default, many of these worlds have their blocks protected, and they are designed to be experienced rather than torn apart for materials. You also can't just start up a fresh game of Minecraft with RTX on outside of these worlds just yet. But since NVIDIA has also released detailed instructions for exactly how designers can craft their own RTX textures and resource packs, it shouldn't be too long until we see a variety of real-time ray tracing enabled user-created content releasing for download in true Minecraft fashion. Now, we've previously covered Minecraft on our RTX Theater series before, but that was via an unofficial path tracing modification released by an independent developer. Now that we have true RTX features straight from NVIDIA, let's dive into the sample worlds and take a look at what you can expect. As we go, you'll be able to peek at the on-screen benchmarks included on the top of the screen, and you'll see that we rarely dipped below 58 frames per second with RTX on, even while also capturing gameplay footage. The PC we're using for this demo is running an ASUS 2080 Super GPU and an Intel i9-9900KS CPU. By default, the Windows 10 version of Minecraft is locked at 60 frames per second, and while you can fiddle with your application data to turn that cap off, it isn't recommended for this graphical beta. RTX features are more about an enhanced visual experience rather than maximizing frame rates. The first RTX world we'll take a look at is called Aquatic Adventure, a creator who's been making Minecraft worlds and sculptures since 2013. This world features an underwater approach to an elaborate castle, followed by a series of minor puzzles that serve as a showcase for ray-traced caustics, which refers to the way that light behaves when passing through water. As you'll immediately notice in the contrast between our RTX on and off footage, NVIDIA recommends that you turn your render distance down when you want the real-time ray tracing features enabled. So, while RTX off might let you see further into the distance, RTX on gives you the mind-blowing lighting and shadow effects that really makes this world come alive. One area where you can really see what RTX brings to Minecraft is in the reflections of the yellow light blocks off the shiny floors and walls in the underwater city. It really enhances an ambiance-focused experience like that. And it's honestly a little bit strange to have these ultra-realistic reflections present inside Minecraft's block-based, totally unrealistic worlds. The Aquatic Adventure world also involves a short trip into an ice cave, complete with some of the RTX illumination features. The cold light reflected off the ice makes for an experience unlike anything that's been possible in Minecraft before. Next up, let's take a look at Of Temples and Totems, a jungle-themed adventure map from Minecraft creator Razzleberries and her team. In this world, you'll explore different elemental-themed temples, battling enemies and solving puzzles. One of the things you'll notice when you start up this world is the instructions in-game to turn off clouds in your options menu. That's because clouds will appear as totally solid blocks with all the RTX enhancements in this world, which ruins the otherwise impressive visual effects. While the dungeon areas of Temples and Totems don't always gain a lot from RTX features, it's all worth it to witness the god rays of light streaking through the jungles, shining between trees. At the right time of the virtual day, it can take your breath away. The different elemental temples in this world do a great job of showing off the different sorts of environments that are possible with Minecraft RTX enhancements. The reflections in the water temples are a really nice touch, but the lava glow in the fire temple is definitely the highlight of the whole experience. In the Crystal Palace world, you'll start on a sailing ship before heading to explore an abandoned fantasy castle, in a map designed by Gemini Tay, another creator who has been making Minecraft content since 2013. 2013. One part of this world that's pretty neat is that outside of the palace, it all looks almost like a traditional game of Minecraft. In the grassy, natural areas, the RTX effects are subtle, but once you get inside, you'll see the light and color enhancements on full display. Crystal Palace showcases some incredible new ways to do lighting inside your structures, including colorful chandeliers and underlit planners. Playing in this world for a while is sure to inspire. After this, you'll want to experiment with your own RTX-enabled home lighting setup. Crystal Palace is also a great world to use if you're looking for a way to play a more traditional Minecraft experience with RTX enabled. You can do this by grabbing the rowboat from your ship or building one yourself and setting sail across the sea in a random direction. After you journey for a while, you'll eventually come to some natural environment because the world options are set to infinite and Minecraft's normal procedural generation will take over. You can start a new Minecraft life out there playing survival from scratch with RTX on. Just be careful not to fall in a big hole full of water that you can't get out of, which we did in this video only to illustrate what not to do. It's exactly what happened. We're totally just looking out for you. It wasn't a ridiculous mistake on our part. Moving right along. The Color, Light, and Shadow World by creator Pearlescent Moon is designed just to show off what Minecraft's RTX features can do. That makes it a little less flavorful and dynamic than some of the others, but a better showcase of specifically what real-time ray tracing adds to the game. The world is separated into distinct areas specifically focusing on different aspects of RTX Minecraft, including a global illumination zone where you can see how light comes through windows and skylights at different times of day as Minecraft's sun moves across the sky. There's also an underwater area that demonstrates reflections and transparency effects via glass and water and should give you some great ideas for new in-game aquariums. Just look at the difference between RTX on and off here. It's amazing stuff. The Color, Light, and Shadow World also includes a variety of small room examples taking advantage of different kinds of illumination, a zone where you can experiment with your own light sources in creative mode, and a puzzle involving combining different colors of light, something that would never have been possible in Minecraft before. But the highlight of the whole experience has to be the infinity mirror effect on display, which is just fantastic. Expect to see this visual trick used a lot by world creators in the future as RTX Minecraft becomes more popular. The next world we'll look at is called Imagination Island, a theme park experience designed by the Minecraft creators known as Blockworks. This place really comes alive at night when the new illumination effects throughout the park are at their most impressive. You get a little bit of everything as you look around Imagination Island, including water reflections, multicolored lighting, and transparency effects across four different lands. There are also a couple of impressively designed roller coasters. In the Canyon Coaster, your cart passes through dynamic shadows, moving from light into darkness as you descend below the cliffs and under trees. And over on the lava coaster, you get a wild ride through the new lighting glow given off by RTX enhanced magma. Of all the worlds, Imagination Island is the one we had the most fun actually playing, with entertaining rides and lots of churros to eat. Last but not least for the Minecraft RTX worlds, feast your eyes on the Neon District, designed by Elysium Fire. This is a popular Java Edition world converted to Windows 10, which gives some exciting glimpses of what might be possible as creators go back and enhance their previously designed Minecraft worlds. We've talked about Quake RTX before here on the channel, so we know that a fresh coat of RTX paint can add a lot of life to an old game. Once Minecraft RTX resource packs are more widely available, any creator who wants to will be able to redesign their old worlds to take advantage of the new RTX effects. The Neon District is best experienced flying around in creative mode, enjoying the dazzling colored light sources that can be found around every corner. In fact, we think this world pretty much speaks for itself, so I'm just gonna shut up for a bit and let you enjoy it with some suitable music. And And that's your tour through the 6 Minecraft RTX worlds available as part of the official beta. Of course, since it is a beta, we did encounter some issues. We had some visual flickering on occasion, and something really weird would happen when pausing or alt-tabbing out of the game, where the world would be brighter for a bit until the RTX effects seemed to kick in. And then the game would gradually process the illumination and shadows correctly. Happily, we didn't run into any major crashes during our testing. But hey, working out these bugs is what a beta is for, right? Make sure to check out the links in the description below to shop for NVIDIA RTX cards and to find the full instructions on getting started with the RTX Minecraft beta. As always, thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on a future installment of RTX Theater.